I know most of you have visited this website called pinterest.com. In this website you can see multiple images, and all these images they are placed so beautifully. This website they reuse masonry layout. So in this video I'm trying to create the clone, or we are trying to mimic the same layout with the help of just few lines of code. And the best part of the video is that we are making it responsive without using any CSS grid, flexbox or media queries. Just wait, there is also the bonus class. In the bonus class, with the help of JavaScript code, I will show you how can you generate random images. You can specify any specific number to generate random images, and all those images they will be generated dynamically. Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jitsaru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. Let's create index.html file. Inside that file, if I type exclamation sign and hit that tab button, then you'll get this basic HTML code. For the title, let's give responsive masonry image gallery without using CSS grid, flexbox and media queries. Now just inside the body tag, let's create div with class name app. Inside that div, I'm creating another div with class name car, and inside that div, let's create image element. For the source, I'm giving images slash pic1.jpg. As you can see, in the same folder, I do have folder name images, and inside that folder, there are different images. So these are the images. Let's save the file. With the help of live server extension, let's open this index.html file in our default browser. Now let's duplicate this image element. And let's give the different source of images. There are very few lines of CSS code, so I'm gonna use internal CSS. Just below the title tag, let's give style tag, and inside that, for the universal selector, in order to prevent the browser's default margin and padding, I'm giving margin and padding of 0, and also for the box sizing to border box. For the div with class name app, I'm giving width of 80 VW. That VW, that means the viewport's width. This is the width, okay. As you can see, our image is really huge. So let's style the images, which is inside the div with class name card. So for the image, I'm giving width of 100%. And now for the class app, if I give the margin top and bottom to 2 rem, and for the left and right auto, then you can see our content is brought exactly at the center of our browser. So this is exactly what I want. Now for the image, if I give the border radius of 1 rem, did you see that rounded corners around that image? Similarly, I want some gap between these images, so I want to give margin bottom to 1 rem. Now it's looking better. Let's duplicate the same code, and now when you hover that image, let's give the transform scale to 1.05 and cursor to pointer. So in the browser, you can see when you hover the image, you'll get some kind of zooming effect, but there's no any transition. So now for the image, let's give the transition duration of 0.2 seconds. For the timing function, let's give is in out. So in the browser, you can see now when you hover, you'll get that smooth transition. Let's take it to the full screen by pressing F11 key. Now let's style the div with class name car. So for the class car, so this is inverted none, okay, just be careful. For the class car, I'm giving columns. For the column count, I'm giving 4, and in the browser you can see you'll get that 4 number of columns. And the interesting part is that the dimension of image, they are adjusted dynamically. What if I change to 3? As you can see, now you'll get the 3 number of columns. Similarly, let's give the gap. For the gap, I'm giving 1 rem. For the image, I have given margin bottom of 1 rem, and I'm giving the same value for that gap as well. Now let's change that column count to 4, and let's give the column width of 12 rem. So in the browser you can see, now by adding that column width to 12 rem, I'm trying to create responsive layout. So no matter what kind of dimension of the images are, how many of the images they are, and these 3 lines of code, they are responsible for creating that responsive layout. So let me show you what's really going on. If I don't give that columns width, let's remove that columns width and let's go back to the browser. If you adjust this screen, did you see that? And there is no any responsiveness. But if I give the columns width, and if I adjust this width of the screen, did you see that? Now it's responsive. and that column's width is somehow connected with widths of its parents, that is David class name app. So let me show you the demo. What if I give to 20 rim? Did you see that? Although the number of columns that we have given for the class car, that was 4, but you can see we're getting only 3 number of columns. As you can see, the 4 number of columns with that width, we are unable to create that because our parent's width is lower. And now image width also depends upon the columns width that we have given for the David class name card. So what if I change that image width to 80%? Did you see that huge gap between columns? That means that image that is not occupying the 100% of its parent's width. So this is all how these elements, they are interconnected with each other. Now it's time for the bonus part of the video. As I have already told you that with the help of JavaScript code, we'll generate the dynamic random images. So now it's time to build that. Okay, we do have very few lines of JavaScript code. So again, I'm using the internal JavaScript code. So just above the end of body tag, let's create the script tag, and inside that I'm creating function name render images, and inside that function let's use the fetch API. For the URL, I'm giving https://source.unsplash.com/random. With the help of this URL, you can generate the random images that you would get in the Unsplash website. Now if our request was success, then it will return us the response. Let's use the arrow function, and I want to show you that response in the console. Let's see what kind of response we are going to get. I have created that render images function, but I haven't called that function. So before that, let's invoke that function. Now in the browser, if you press F12 key and if you go to the console tab, as you can see in the response, we are getting lots of data. Other data, they are not so useful, but the important one is that URL. Okay, so if I give response.url, then we can achieve that URL. So before that, first of all, let's create the image element. So I'm writing let img is equal to document.createElement. So we're creating the image element. Now you can give source for the image similar to HTML code. So we can write img.src. We are giving the source attribute for that image, and for the source attribute, you can pass that response.url. Now you can see we have created image element with source, but it's time to insert that image element inside the div with class name card. First of all, we need to select that div with class name card. So I'm writing const card is equal to document.querySelector class card, and now we want to insert that image element inside that div. So for that, I'm writing card.appendChild. We want to append the image, okay? So let's pass the img variable. Now in the browser, you can see extra image is generated. And if I refresh, you can see you'll get the random images. I think this is really cool. But as you can see, when you refresh, you are getting only single image. What if you want to generate multiple images? So for that, first of all, let's create a variable name number of images, and I'm giving 25. And let's use the for loop. Initially, let's give the I value to 0, and for the condition, let's give if I is less than number of images, then we will increase I value by 1. So inside that for loop, let's call the function name render images. So now with the help of this for loop, we are invoking render images function 25 times. Okay, so now with the help of that variable number of images, you can specify total number of images that you want to get. So now let's go back to the browser, and you can see 25 more random images, they are dynamically generated. And if I refresh, you can see each time you'll get different random images, and the cool part is that it is responsive. So let me show you. If you adjust this screen, did you see that? It's totally responsive, and we did this all with the help of just few lines of CSS code, and we didn't use any CSS grid, flexbox or any media queries. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it, and also if you haven't already hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn, so keep learning.